Now, the German Chancellor has warned people here not to relax and let down their guard as restrictive measures here start to be eased. For more on Germany's response to the coronavirus, our chief political editor, Michelle Kufner, is with the German Health Minister, Jens Spahn. Hi, Michelle.
Yes, hi there. Indeed, the German Health Minister, Jens Spahn, is with me right now. Minister, Germany's health care system has so far escaped the stress test many had predicted. Some clinics are even considering taking in non-essential operations once again. What is Germany doing different from other countries?
Well, first of all, that Germany has got through this so well so far actually makes us humble and not overconfident, because we know this was only the first wave. This is a long run and not a short sprint. But so far we are doing well because of a healthcare system actually that was very well prepared in a good shape. So to say, I'm standing on the shoulders of giants, since this is a success story of many governments. We have a very good network, for example, of general practitioners that take care of the milder cases, the softer cases. 6 out of 7 COVID patients, for example, are treated with general practitioners and not in hospitals. So hospitals are not overrun. And then traditionally, we have a very high capacity of ICUs, of intensive care capacities in the hospitals, and that is, of course, very helpful in this situation.
Now, German Chancellor Angela Merkel spoke of a fragile success. Now Germany is partially easing some of those restrictions. You will only learn in 2 weeks' time what the actual impact was. What is your main concern going into these 2 weeks now?
Well, we still need to learn which measure actually has which result regarding new infections, cases, dynamic situation. No one really knows, no one in the world, if you close shops, if you close restaurants, if you stop social life, if you close kindergartens, for example, what really makes a difference and to what extent. So actually we need to learn step by step. What just happened today, open up smaller shops again, what difference makes that to the dynamic of the outbreak? Is there any or is there none? And you can only tell after 2 weeks, because it takes time till you can see it in the statistics. And so we have decided to have a step-by-step approach back to a new normal. We do some steps as today, shops and schools, for example, in some Bundesländer, federal states. And then in 2 weeks, we might take a next step with much precaution. I prefer an approach that says, let's do it step by step, slowly, carefully, but in a way that actually is very reliable and has no need of turning someone in this journey.
What's your concrete expectation how much infection rates could rise through this opening now?
Well, to frankly spoken, no one really can tell, because what people have learned, and I'm very proud and thankful for my German fellows, actually, what many have learned and do live in their all-day's life is keeping distance, for example, wearing masks in public transport, for example, and that itself makes already a difference. And what we know, what we all know, is that this needs to be in place for months to come, until there is a vaccination. There will be some things in our all-day's life that really needs to be changed all the time through, and that is mainly keeping distance. And as long as people have that in mind, that makes always a difference to the world before.
Now, you yourself have put a lot of emphasis on regional health authorities and the tracking of cases and containing cases. You've presented a whole host of measures today, and that also includes bringing along the digitalization in those regions. Is that the Achilles heel? Is that what the German government's missed and is now suffering for in this crisis?
Well, in this federal state of Germany, we have different levels, the community level, the federal states level, and the national level, actually. And what we see is, yes, we should have invested more in previous years in the digitalization of to actually make these different levels better interacting in a situation like this, that new cases that are found in a community within seconds, actually, are known with our national CDC. That is not yet the case. It takes 1 to 2 days till we have the information here in Berlin. And that is just a example, but a very important one to have a real picture of this outbreak that we want to change through digitalization and to actually support and to fund these investments that need to be taken in the communities. And we really want to speed up. That's a chance in this crisis, actually, to speed up digitalization in the public health system.
Now, there's a lot of debate about European solidarity and also Germany's solidarity in this crisis. Germany is taking in patients from abroad. How far will German solidarity go? Will that also include potentially sending personnel or equipment or even as far as Corona bonds?
Well, in general, we were, for example, able to donate a couple of hundreds of ventilators to Spain, Italy, France, the UK, countries that we wanted to support that have helped us in the past. And so now we could have been helpful for them. We have taken patients, as you just mentioned, from abroad, from other countries. We have an exchange. I mean, there were times when others helped us, and now we can give, for example, masks, some at least, medical masks to Belgium or Polish neighbor. So we want to be of help as much as we can in these difficult days. I'm very convinced, you know, at the very beginning, once again in a crisis, the European Union seemed to be somehow disorganized. And it took some time till we pulled everything together. But now what we see is altogether we are stronger, and I'm very confident actually that we are getting out of this stronger than before. Regarding the economy, for example, we have packed a 500 billion economic stimulus that is to help to send incentives for investment where it is needed and to help those countries that actually need to invest in their health system as well. And it's helpful for us too, by the way, since we have obviously some economic trouble as well. And in this, we are together, and that shows the health system as well as the economic situation.
Many fear it could also tear Europe apart, though. You say it will bring Europe together.
As I said at the very beginning, there was a stressful time for Europe, and there is, of course, as soon as you discuss concrete measures, concrete packages, there's always a discussion, which is quite normal because there are different interests between the 27 member states. But as always, when it is needed, we come to a result. And what is important for us as an approach of Germany and of many other countries, we are in a European solidarity. And at the same time, we don't want to have any incentives for the future that might lead the wrong way. So to find the right balance between financial soundness and European solidarity, and that is actually what we have reached so far. So yes, there are debates, and some of them are stressful, but that is important. In the end, we are stronger together.
Jens Spahn, Germany's health minister, thank you very much. And with that, back to the studio.
All right.